What's up, Fox 10 Fox, and today we're putting this against that.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the championship you've been waiting for. Power versus efficiency, speed versus agility. Today, we are pinning two very capable opponents against one another in the championship fight to find who wins. In the left corner, the Mech 15 G3 Ultra. Starring an Intel Core i7-10-8758H 8-core processor with a 5.1 GHz boot clock, a full HD 240Hz IPS display, 1TB PCIe NVMe SSD, and 16GB of DDR4 RAM clocked at 2666 MHz. Put your hands together for the champion! With a B450 motherboard, a Ryzen 9 3900X, a GTX 1080, and 32GB of 3200MHz DDR4 RAM with a whopping 10.5TB of storage, it is going to be a match for the races. So please, sit at the edge of your seats, grab a snack, and get ready for the ultimate Mech 15 review.
So then, what I have here are the two monitors, and I have everything turned off that I need to have turned off on these for it to just be straight up results for Cinebench, giving it the best chance I possibly can by turning off every excess bloatware. I do have Control Center up on my laptop right now because I'm going to turn Fan Boost on to give it the best chance against a Ryzen 9 3900X. So without any further ado, let's do it. I apologize if the audio is not as good as it should be, but that's because I do not have a sticky mic and my other mic is meant for me sitting down. All right, we got Fan Boost on. I'm going to close out of Command Center. And before I get started, for the sake of fairness, I do have it running on this monitor against this monitor because these are the exact same monitor, the LG 144Hz 32-inch. But as a very positive thing about this laptop, the display on this thing is incredible. It's probably one of the best SDR monitors I've ever seen. Granted, it's not even close to HDR, but the color and contrast is fantastic. And again, for being 240Hz, that's all I'm asking for. It exceeds expectations, so the monitor is doing great. So without any further ado, let's launch up Cinebench. Ready for this? And bam. So here's my prediction. The Ryzen 9 3900X is just gonna absolutely destroy the Intel i7-10875H in multi-threaded performance. But for single-core performance, I think that the Intel is going to win. We're going to find that out really quick. Look how fast that one finished compared to that one. So the Ryzen 5 is already finished with a new high score today, 7153. And the Intel with a new high score as well, 4422. So my prediction was correct. Clearly, Ryzen 9 is going to win this one. But let's do the single core performance test and see what happens, because I'm holding out hope for my Intel here. This is gonna take 4 years. They're done. I'm excited to see what happens. Well, my hypothesis was wrong. Here I thought Intel could still stand on the tower, on the throne, saying, "It is me, the gaming champion." And perhaps if I had a laptop with an i9 in it magically, that would be the case. But today, it fell 7 points behind the Ryzen 9 3900X. I'm a bit disappointed. I thought it was gonna win, but it's okay. Because what really matters now, that we got the CPU out of the way, which obviously matters, it's a huge point, but what matters now, this has a full fat 2070 Super in it, and that has a GTX 1080. A desktop chip versus a laptop chip. Granted, it's not the Max-Q version, but I'm still very curious to see what happens. And again, we're gonna do hypothesis time. I think my laptop's gonna win this one.
So in Gears 5, the average frame rate for my laptop was 83.2 frames per second,
with the 2070 Supermax Q. And for the GTX 1080, we had 97.9 FPS on average. In Far Cry 5, on the laptop, at 1080p, we saw an average FPS of 90, a max FPS of 112, and a minimum FPS of 70. On the GTX 1080, we saw a minimum FPS of 89, an average FPS of 106, and a maximum FPS of 127. Similar results with the GTX 1080 pulling slightly ahead with everything at max settings at 1080p.
So then, final verdict time. Going straight from a non-objective standpoint, as you can tell by the figures, the laptop lost. Especially more CPU intensive tasks, and the fact that my computer has double the amount of RAM that's in the laptop really didn't give it much of a chance. But, does that mean I dismiss laptops altogether? The exact opposite. And the more objective review, I love my laptop. Mom, since I know you watch my videos, I don't think Dad watches my videos to the end, so I think I'm safe here, but Mom, if you're watching and Dad's in earshot, stop listening. I don't think I expected this video to be me getting emotional about a piece of plastic, well, aluminum, but the laptop has given me a reinvigoration for video games and gaming in general, and it's made me want to play video games more than my desktop does. And I think that from here on out, you will not see me with a desktop. Obviously, I'm going to use my desktop until I go to college, but when I move to my own place, then I'm going to switch from desktops to laptops because they're so much more fun to me. I don't know why. I love the fact that they're tiny. I think that the portability is a huge factor for me. I can lift that up with like two fingers. It's 4.6 pounds. And it blows my mind that it has close to the exact same amount of power as my PC, which genuinely does cost more, but it's so surprising to me to see how far laptops have gone. And if you're in the market for a laptop, I know this is gonna sound like I'm a shill or whatever, but buy Electronics. There's no other laptop company that I recommend you buying from. All the other laptop companies decided, hey, let's be extremely overpriced. They'll charge about $200 to $300 more than this company right here. So I give them my full endorsement because what you are getting is more powerful than like 80% of users on Steam for $2,000. And just in case you're curious, on PC Part Picker, I built a similar system, full fat 2070 in it, and it came out to be about $1,900. So for $100 more, you're getting a really small form factor. And I think that if you are in the market for a laptop, whether that means you're going to college, need it for business travels and everything like that, I would highly, highly recommend you buy something like this. Even if it's not Electronics, if you end up finding yourself liking Razer more or something along those lines, absolutely go ahead. You will not be disappointed with the performance of this thing, and it will last you for, I can guarantee you, at least, I'd say 4 years. Now, just as a quick side note, the Electronics laptop does have a lot of upgradability. I think that was probably one of the best things that I saw was, although I ordered it with 16 gigs of RAM, as time goes on, I'll probably take those sticks out, replace them with 32 gigs inside. But at the same time, today I just got my shipment in that I put in the laptop. That changed it from a 1 terabyte NVMe all the way up to 3 terabytes because I got a 2 terabyte NVMe for $200. So now I have 3 terabytes in my laptop. So the upgradability is pretty great, although you can't upgrade CPU and GPU. I don't see you needing to upgrade GPU, especially because it is a 1080p display. Granted, it's one of the best 1080p displays I've ever seen, but in terms of the 30 series coming out, although the 30 series is probably gonna destroy, you're not gonna need to worry about not being able to run the latest and greatest games because you have already an 8-core processor, which is what the Series X is designed for, as well as the PS5. You also have an RTX 2070 Super, which means that if more games gravitate towards ray tracing, hopefully they become more optimized, you'll be able to use that feature as opposed to buying a 1080 or something along those lines. And to top it all off, if you don't care about gaming, which I don't know if you buy a gaming laptop, but let's say in 4 years the GPU starts to become a bit obsolete. The chances of your CPU still being absolutely perfectly fine, perhaps you want to get like a Razer Core or something like that and upgrade to an eGPU, I think that this processor has what it takes to really take it to the next level. I was really impressed by the single core, and I was really, really impressed by the multi-core test as well. I mean, you're looking at something better than, I believe it was a 2700X and just below a 3700X for a laptop chip. So you're looking at what I would consider it to be Intel's top dog right now in terms of laptops. I think that that hasn't changed yet. Because although most laptops are configured with an i7, if you've got more of a budget, feel free to go for an i9, and that thing will absolutely dominate anything that Ryzen has to offer on the laptop market. Thank you very much for watching the video. If you liked it, do what you usually do, and as always, buy yourself something nice, like and subscribe if you want to see more tech stuff. And if you don't like all the tech stuff, I'm sorry, but it seems like you guys wanted more, and I really wanted to get my review done before I focus more on games again.
Years ago, one of my favorite games, Micro Center, and seeing the Asus Nitro 5 with a GTX 1050, and I was two steps away from the Electronics laptop, which is awesome, and then I saw the Electronics laptop, which is awesome, and I was going to get the Electronics, and I was like, I know I've got to get that. That was a year ago. Now I'm going.